And speaking of which, before we've moved on further with the history, just you saying, to be able to give back to the community and stuff. I'm just curious because you've always been an artist who's worked with the underground cats. You have no problem working with underground up and coming artists. You'll always lend your hand to them. You know what I mean?
One thing about me, I want to work with every artist, man. I always wanted to work with every artist. Everybody who has an idea about music, I wanted to try to add to their idea and help blow it up, you know what I'm saying? And blow up myself, you know what I'm saying? I always wanted to do well, and I always appreciate it because I came from it. You come from nothing, you know? I never heard of you, homie. And then I heard of you. I heard your record on the radio, yo. It's fresh, you know what I'm saying? So I wanted to always help my up-and-comers do that as well, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and it like doing so, because ever since we've known each other, we first linked while working on a track together, and you've always been very, just very down to work with other artists, and you promote the song, you don't get them in the cats, you're about building with them. Is there any cats like who coming up in New Jersey right now around where you're at? Like, do you got your eye on right now that you like,
Oh, man, it's mad rappers over here, bro. A lot of rappers. Like, and it's some popular ones like, Arsenal. Yeah. Arsenal from the beat, from the battles. He's from around here. You know what I'm saying? And, Sue Surf.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And we got a dude. His name is Double O. He was on Redman albums. You know what I'm saying? It's a bunch of rappers around here. My partner, his name is R. Yo, one of the freshest rappers you're going to hear, man. Like, we always had a bunch of talent. You know what I'm saying? And still to this day, I run up the hill to Queen Latifah's aunt lives up there. You know what I'm saying? Word. And, I still go up there and rap and listen to the niggas rap, and I be rapping. You know what I'm saying? It's still the same game. You know what I mean? You got to listen to the kids rap, and I rap, and everybody be like, yo, we a community here in New Jersey, you know what I mean? Because we don't have our own radio station. New York has the radio stations, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And Philly has the radio stations, and we're in between. We don't have our own station. So you gotta rub elbows. I got to go to New York to get on the radio, or I got to go to Philly to get on the radio. So I'm always open to, just people rapping. You know what I'm saying? I never call people corny. You know what I'm saying? Unless we in some kind of like battle or something, or I have to do that. But I don't think no rappers are corny, bro. Yeah. I always like learn something from what other people spit and whatnot. You know what I'm saying? So I enjoy it. Actually, it's a personal joy, and it pays the bills too. So you know what I'm saying? It's all good.
Definitely, man.
But back to the Dougie rappers, there's a bunch of them. It's Solo for Dolo, my man Ren Thomas. I seen him the other day.
I've heard of Ren, yeah.
Yeah, it's just a bunch of rappers, man. Good ones, too. And some are popular, and some are on their way to being popular. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, I commend you, too, man, because you always lend your helping hand to, up and coming, and you help them out, man. And a lot of dudes in the position do that, like, funny stories, like Reef the Lost Cause recently posted, and this is no shade, but he's like, I remember when Sean Price used to hustle verses, and he's like, he would sell 20 you motherfuckers the same verse on different nothing you could do about it.
Yo, Sean was my boy. Matter of fact, me, Sean P, Reef the Lost Cause, Curious, Papoose, we all got a song together.
Oh, yeah.
It's called We Don't Give a Fuck. It's not that it didn't become popular, to the mainstream, but yo, I'm proud of that song because yo, my man Ralph Dog put it together, and yo, it's got so many people on it. Sadat X on it. Yo, it's so many King Magnetic is on it. There's so many people on it that I'm just so proud of it. And, I was always cool with Sean P and the Boot Camp Click. I used to open up for them back in like 2005. I was opening for them. I got to travel with them a little bit. So I know all of them. And Tech and Steel and Strang. I love them boys. So you know what I'm saying? But P, you know, and now I work with P Homeboy. I be doing mad joints with Rusty Jux.
Oh, yeah.
You
know?
I do mad joints with Jux. We got at least 4 or 5 joints together. Even though other people put them together, they always pick me and Jux to rap together. So, yo, man, it's just I'm blessed and I'm happy and I don't got the corona. So I'm double happy, you know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? Everything is good.
That'd be dope if you and Jux put something together, like a little EP or something. That would be dope.
I think we got enough songs for that. I got to look into it. Right now, we're doing one with my man, Big Bob. You know what I mean? I ain't laid my verse yet, but I'm gonna do my verse for the joint with Jux. And me and Bob, we got one with Ren Thomas coming. I work with Ren Thomas and Jux a lot because, you know, they like me. They premiere in the underground, and they keep it pushing. You know what I'm saying? And
yeah.
I get a lot of work with them, so I do that. And we got a couple others, too. I did Big Bob is a good dude. I got a Grand Pooba joint off with him. You know what I mean? He's a good dude.
Yeah, Big Bob works with one of my homeboys from out here in Toronto, too. He's got a few joints with
him. I'm happy you don't got the corona, Kels. That shit is killing people, man. I was just watching Governor Cuomo and Governor Murphy talk about it. And, yo, man, that shit is serious, man. You know what I'm saying? I hope everybody being healthy and doing what we supposed to do, stay 6 feet from people. You know what I mean? It can't help but talk about it in the interview because it's so prevalent in the community right now. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, man. You know, it's crazy how many people been getting it and shit, you know, just – I think, like, here in, you know, Toronto, we started taking it pretty young before it became big. So I'm just hoping, you know, that it kind of helps. It doesn't turn into monsters became in some other places.